Good evening and welcome to St. Ambrose. Our opening song tonight is number 64, Let the King of Glory Come, number 64 in the Breaking Bread books.
Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
I'm not going to say MC, because we're not there yet. But this is still an important celebration, this whole week of Advent in a single day. We've been waiting for the Lord, waiting on his promises. And now we're almost close enough to taste it. Let us listen to the word of God tonight. Let us discover anew our communion in the Lord Jesus. And now at the beginning, let us acknowledge our own need for healing and forgiveness.
Lord Jesus, you came to call sinners. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the one we are waiting for. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the Savior of the world. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Pour forth, we beseech you, O Lord, your grace into our hearts, that we, to whom the incarnation of Christ, your Son, was made known by the message of an angel, may by his passion and cross be brought to the glory of his resurrection, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the second book of Samuel. When King David was settled in his palace, and the Lord had given him rest from his enemies on every side, he said to Nathan the prophet, "Here I am living in a house of cedar, while the ark of God dwells in a tent." Nathan answered the king, "Go, do whatever you have in mind, for the Lord is with you. But that night the Lord spoke to Nathan and said, Go tell my servant David, thus says the Lord, should you build me a house to dwell in? I who took you from the pasture and from the care of the flock to be commander of my people Israel. I have been with you wherever you went, and I've destroyed all your enemies before you. And I will make you famous like the great ones of the earth. I will fix a place for my people Israel. I will plant them so that they may dwell in their place without further disturbance. Neither shall the wicked continue to afflict them as they did of old, since the time I was first appointed judges over my people Israel. I will give you rest from all your enemies. The Lord also reveals to you that he will establish a house for you. And when your time comes and you rest with your ancestors, I will raise up your heir after you, sprung from your loins, and I will make his kingdom firm. I will be a father to him, and he shall be a son to me. Your house and your kingdom shall endure forever before me. Your throne shall stand firm forever. The word of the Lord.
The words to our responsory, forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, to him who can strengthen you, according to my gospel and the proclamation of Jesus Christ, according to the revelation of the mystery kept secret for long ages, but now manifested through the prophetic writings and according to the command of the eternal God, made known to all nations to bring about the obedience of faith. To the only wise God, through Jesus Christ, be glory forever and ever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The angel Gabriel was sent from God to a town of Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man named Joseph of the house of David. And the virgin's name was Mary. And coming to her, he said, "Hail, full of grace, the Lord is with you." But she was greatly troubled at what was said and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. Then the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. Behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall name him Jesus. And he will be called Great, the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of David his father, and he will rule over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." But Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I have no relations with a man?" The angel said to her in reply, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be called Holy, the Son of God. And behold, Elizabeth, your relative, has also conceived a son in her old age. And this is the sixth month for her who was called barren. For nothing will be impossible for God." Mary said, "Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord. May it be done to me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Yes, we are in the fourth week of Lent, It started for this parish at 5 o'clock this evening, and it will end at 4 o'clock tomorrow evening. One day. It doesn't happen very often. I don't know, I'm not that kind of an astronomer to figure this all out and how the calendar works, so. But we knew it was coming, and we sort of planned for it. So don't look at any of these decorations up here. Just pretend they're not here. And you notice the lights aren't on, so most of you, that will allow you to take that long-lost nap, because we have passed into the, what is it called? The, not the summer solstice, not the fall solstice. Winter. Whatever. We're in winter. And it's Michigan, so you don't know what the weather will be. Some places do, but we never do. The promise of God is the message for this weekend. Is it about to be fulfilled in our time? We may ask, how in this time? It was over 2,000 years ago that Christ was born. The manifestation of the Messiah is given in increments by God. I caught that phrase from somewhere. I don't remember where. And then I said, how can that be, given in increments? God does something, it's done, right? The increments are, in fact, in these readings especially, the Old Testament reading, David receives a message through the prophet Nathan that the Messiah will come from his line. Now, David had been wandering around fighting everybody in the world, trying to establish, well, in the known world at that time, establish his kingdom. And he was finally able to rest. And he wanted to build a new temple. I don't know if there ever was another temple, probably not. Wanted to build the temple. That's kind of like us trying to build a church. It takes a lot of dough and a lot of time. And they didn't have those big cranes to lift those beams up. They had to do all that by hand. And he was all ready to go. He talked to Nathan. Nathan says, yep, sure, go do it. But God came to Nathan that night and said, yes, the prophet will be from your line, but you will not be building me a temple. There's more to that, but I'm not going to get into it here. If we go, so that's the first time that we heard that the Messiah would be coming. The second time was in Paul, in his epistle to the Romans. He makes it known that through the prophets, the manifestation is made known to all the nations through Jesus Christ. Seems a little out of order, because this is after Christ had rose from the dead and ascended into heaven. But he's talking to the Romans when he's trying to convince them to remain in their Christian faith and to look for the fact that God is being manifest at that time through Jesus Christ. Not any of those foreign gods or any of that stuff. And now we get to the good stuff. I think it's the good stuff. In this gospel, Mary receives the manifestation of the Messiah. And is told by the angel Gabriel that she is to be an instrument of that manifestation. Gabriel is speaking the message that God gave him. He really doesn't have a him or her, but we have to give him something. So it's the message of God. God does not force this, his will upon Mary. He could have, but he didn't. He asked her to accept the manifestation of Christ. And as we know from the gospel reading, she begins by stating that she does not understand how this can be, that she can be the mother of Christ, because she is betrothed to Joseph, but they are not yet married. Gabriel assures her that it will be through the overshadowing of the Holy Spirit that she will become pregnant, and that the child to be born will be holy, the Son of God. Mary, in her humility, assents to God by saying, "Behold, I am the servant of the Lord. May it be done to me according to your word. It's strange that even at that time, Mary knew that even though she was being addressed by an angel, which was very unusual in that time, that he was, or the angel was, carrying the very word of God himself. It was finally fulfilled when Christ was conceived. You may ask, how can that be? And that Christ would be fulfilled in our time as well. I ask you, isn't the coming of the Messiah fulfilled every time we celebrate Christmas, each year? We also celebrate each time we make someone else's Christmas special. We have an opportunity to give gifts to those we love. We have an even greater opportunity when we do it for someone who cannot count on it. That's why we have the giving tree out. It's in the back still. It's lit. To give to those who are less fortunate. For ourselves too, we can give the gift in reconciliation and on Christmas by receiving the newborn Christ in the Eucharist. Then we accept Christ as Mary did by stating, "Behold, I am the servant of the Lord. May it be done to me according to your word."
Let's stand together now and profess our faith. I believe in one God, Father Almighty,
maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible.
I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ,
the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven.
And by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate, set us up to death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures.
He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end.
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life,
who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Grateful for God's promises, grateful for God's fulfillment of promises in the past, we bring these prayers.
For the church, may the Lord continue to help her grow in humble witness to his glory. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace and harmony in all nations of the world, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are suffering extreme pain or fear, may Christ, the divine physician, calm them and grant them peace of mind. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this assembly, may Jesus strengthen us as we seek to build God's kingdom here on earth. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died in the light of faith, may they forever praise the Lord in heaven with all the angels and saints. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those in our book of intentions and those calling and requesting prayers, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our sister diocese in Lodwar, Kenya, our sister parish in Guatemala, and our St. Ambrose parish family, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Harold and Edna Nidau, for whom this Mass is offered, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us invite the intercession of our Blessed Mother as we say, Hail Mary,
full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
We pray through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Our song during the preparation of the gifts is number 707, Hail Mary, Gentlewoman. 707.
Chosen.
Dear brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
May the Holy Spirit, O Lord, sanctify these gifts laid upon your altar, just as he filled with his power the womb of the Blessed Virgin Mary. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
For all the oracles of the prophets foretold him, the Virgin Mother longed for him with love beyond all telling. John the Baptist sang of his coming and proclaimed his presence when he came. It is by his gift that already we rejoice at the mystery of his nativity, so that he may find us watchful in prayer and exultant in his praise. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. Fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
And we eat his bread and drink his blood.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of Jesus' death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout and bring her
through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. The Savior's command and formed by Jesus' own divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of Christ's peace.
Peace, 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 peace,
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord,
I am not worthy to enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Our communion song is number 73, Bread of Life. We will sing the first two verses, which are the Advent verses.
Give us now.
The parish office will be closed on Monday, December 25th, and Monday, January 1st. Thank you to all the volunteers who in some way contributed to the Gunther family funeral and luncheon. We are very grateful. And the music for the 7 o'clock Christmas Eve Mass tomorrow will begin at 6:30 p.m. Please come and enjoy the music. May God bless each one of you.
Let's stand and pray. Having received this pledge of eternal redemption, we pray, Almighty God, that as the feast day of our salvation draws ever nearer, so we may press forward all the more eagerly to the worthy celebration of the mystery of your Son's nativity, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Tomorrow, the Christmas Masses are at 4 o'clock and 7 o'clock. Choir music beginning at 6:30 for the 7 o'clock. And then Christmas morning, 10 o'clock. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless us all, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Let's go forth to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thanks be to God.
Our closing song is O Come, O Come, Emmanuel, number 39 in the Breaking Bread book. We will begin with verse 3.